Towards the late 2000s, China's economy was booming at an unprecedented rate. Many big American brands flocked to the East to capitalize on this new and exciting market, and Barbie was one of them. In 2009, Mattel, Barbie's manufacturer, invested well over $30 million in building their first flagship store in Shanghai. They called it the House of Barbie. This 36,000-square-foot store held the world's largest collection of Barbie dolls and the most comprehensive collection of licensed Barbie products. It also came with a Barbie salon, with spa and nail treatments. Girls could design their own dolls at the studio while doing a fashion show at a miniature runway. Mattel went above and beyond to make sure that this flagship store was a dream come true for the little girls in China, and they were hoping that this investment would become profitable in the future. Mattel's decision to tap the Chinese market wasn't a big surprise to anyone. Before opening their store in Shanghai, the Chinese consumers seemed to be quite receptive to the Barbie dolls already. Some analysts feared that Barbie's blonde hair and blue eyes were too foreign to Chinese girls, but the sales proved otherwise. The Chinese girls even liked the blonde Barbie better than the localized Chinese Barbie called Ling. To capitalize on this small growing market, Mattel hoped that building this flagship store would improve sales in China. But what really motivated Barbie to enter the Chinese market was the 2008 financial crisis. With the economic downturn looming in the background, the local US sales of Barbie dolls fell significantly. To revitalize their profits, Mattel looked to expand their market internationally in Asia. At that time, Shanghai represented 11% of Chinese GDP and was seen as the urbanized driver of the modern Chinese economy. Many retailers saw Shanghai as the test market. Brands like Best Buy and Adidas were among some of the first ones. However, in March 2011, after only 2 years of operations, Mattel announced they were closing down the House of Barbie. And just like that, $30 million of investment evaporated. So, what were the real reasons that Barbie Shanghai failed to live up to its expectations? And what were some of the blind spots that Mattel executives didn't see? Forbes journalist Helen Wang theorized that Barbie was never an established cultural icon in China. In comparison, Barbie has a rich history in America. Many little girls grow up seeing this doll as an iconic symbol of femininity. Over the past 60 years, the Barbie brand intertwined not only the retail market, but also the entertainment industry like movies or TV shows. It's a cultural icon, but in China, Barbie is just a generic doll with pretty clothes. She doesn't bring the same level of cultural significance to the girls in China. The House of Barbie in Shanghai heavily promoted branded products and merchandise, but none of it meant anything to the consumers. Building a standalone store seemed to be a little too premature. One major blind spot that the Mattel executives missed was that the Chinese perceived the concept of femininity differently than Americans. In America, femininity is about being strong, independent, and smart. The dazzling outfits that Barbie wears are about expressing yourself. The dolls allow kids to dress them in many different ways, and they're encouraged to be creative with the outfit or accessory choices. But in China, femininity means something completely different. It's about being sweet, cute, and loving. To the Chinese girls, the westernized Barbie products were too edgy, or some may even call them too sexy. Instead of modifying their business model to fit the Chinese values, Mattel went ahead and brought the same marketing tactics from the States over to the East, hoping that the celebrated Barbie culture in America would also be profitable in China. Obviously, it backfired. On the other hand, Hello Kitty, a cartoon character from Japan, took over China in a few short years with almost no marketing efforts. Now, there's a Hello Kitty theme park, a Hello Kitty store, even a Hello Kitty restaurant. You name it, they got it. Hello Kitty embodies the Japanese kawaii culture, and it fits really well with the Chinese idea of femininity. And so, Hello Kitty was able to take over China with themed stores and restaurants. Although Mattel did make an effort to promote Barbie doll Ling along with the House of Barbie, they failed to understand that having a Chinese doll would not change the Barbie brand. Ling is Chinese, and she wears Chinese dresses, but she still represents an Americanized concept of femininity. When Mattel spearheaded the campaign to bring Barbie to China, they wanted to target the newly risen Chinese middle class. They specifically built the House of Barbie in the city's most luxurious shopping district, hoping to attract wealthy families and consumers through the door. Likewise, the merchandise in the store was expensive. For example, a pair of jeans cost about US$135. But what Mattel failed to realize was that the middle class families in China preferred spending on education, such as books and violin lessons, rather than on toys. Overpriced Barbie merchandise came very secondary in their priorities. Also, the store experience with a full salon and a design studio was too overwhelming, and Chinese parents didn't see the need to spend that amount of money just for a toy. To make matters worse, The Barbie dolls and merchandise sold in other department stores nearby were much less expensive. Mattel realized too late that they created their own competition by building the store. The House of Barbie was 6 floors high. It took a lot of overhead to maintain the building, yet the superstore was not bringing enough cash to keep the lights on. As a result, Mattel had no choice but to close it down after only 2 years of operations. It was a wake-up call not only to Mattel, but to other American brands who attempted to crack into the Chinese market. Although Mattel's costly venture in Shanghai was a failure, they were not giving up yet. Ever since the closure of the store, Mattel kept reinventing their doll designs to cater to the Chinese consumers. In 2013, they introduced a new doll to China. Only this time, they featured a doll with a violin to appeal to Chinese parents. Will Mattel come back to China with another megastore in the future? Only time will tell.